So are you getting the most out of your Google My Business insights? Do you really understand how those reports can help you? I mean, is there a simple way to find out how people have reacted to some of the changes you've made already in the 14 or 15 days we've spent together? Well, you know, Google Insights is going to give you lots of clues as to what's working and what approach you should be taking for the next 2 weeks as well. I think for most businesses, they have like a locked door of opportunity. And it's almost like rather than struggle to open the door with a key, they just look elsewhere or they just keep doing the same thing, hoping one day it's going to work. Google My Business Insights is telling you what is working. And it could be that it's going to reveal to you some of the things that you didn't even realize were working for you. So once you've opened this door and you understand how insights work, you'll get a lot more information about what you should be doing as opposed to what you are doing and whether that's working. So if you've got that locked door, without the key, you're not ever going to get that door open. The key is Google My Business Insights. Use it. Open up and see what opportunities are still available to you in your local SEO area. So the lesson today is that insights is the key to more customers. And I'm going to show you two of my accounts and I'm going to look into them with you and see, have what I've been doing for the last few weeks been working for me? But why am I so passionate about insights? Well, because Google themselves is passionate about it too. They keep using insights, they keep updating it. It's had a few updates in just the last few months, and it's trying to become the user's tool. And also you've got to bear in mind what Google actually say about Google My Business Insights. Knowing which Google platform is driving traffic to your business gives you an insight into the intention of your potential customers. Well, in plain English, what it means is that you can already find out what your customers want you to do from insights. You'll find out where they're coming from, whether they're on a mobile or a desktop, whether they're interested in calling you or messaging you, or whether they want to book with you. You'll find out what they're using to find you. You'll find out whether they're on maps or on search, whether you're using particular keywords that you haven't considered. All that information is easily available and it's easy to understand. And I'm going to show you exactly how I use that information to help me with my businesses. Now, one of the things I've been trying to work on with Leru is to try and be found in the window cleaning services near me or window cleaners near me. I've been wanting to get local people that are using the words near me to see whether they appear as well. So I'm going to find out whether that's had an impact, because that's something that we were working on together in the last few weeks. So I'm going to Leru Window Cleaning Services here, and I'm going to go into Insights. And this is the old Insights. So it just gives you an idea when you post images, you get traffic. When you look through here, you get an idea in the last month, what types of actions are people taking. So you can see a visit to the website, 8 people have done that. One's called and one's messaged. And then this shows the type of area it's covering, which is the Southbourne area, which we've been working again using other tools in a previous video. I think yesterday I showed you how I do that. And then we got a bit more information and we see we're now well above average on the photos. And that brings in again, lots of views, lots of traffic. So we're more than double on that as well, 140% increase there. But the bit that I want you to be looking at today is this part here, see new profile performance. And the fact that Google's producing a new report means that Google is investing heavily in this. And what it does, it just shows you that each month, so these are each month, so in April, nothing, in May, we had 3, June, we had 1, and July, so far, we've got 2 interactions. And these interactions can include calls, messages, and bookings. Now, I don't think we've got a booking form set up as such, but we have had a couple of messages through the app, which we've responded to, and we've had, 7 phone calls. But most importantly, that's what I was interested in. I was getting this word near me out there. So window cleaners near me, and that has become our top search term, which is good to see. Also, we're trying to get a bit of branding on it as well. So Leru window cleaning, those are areas I've been trying to get some traffic from as well. If we click on here, we get a fuller understanding of what people are searching for. So I know Southbourne was another keyword we've been using. Window and gutter cleaners near me. But the near me, that's kind of the one I've been working on with Leru window cleaning. So we're seeing it's beginning to bring in a bit of traffic. Now, don't forget, this is still a very new business. It's only just been set up. So at this point, this is where I try and engage you to be more involved in this video by thinking about your business and asking yourself questions and being honest with them as well. So here's a few questions that, just thinking of your business, have you gone to your insights and what actually was working? Now, for you to answer that, if you haven't done that already, then after this video, you need to go away and then come back to this video and then answer that question. What have you been doing for the last few weeks? What search terms and keywords did you use? And are they beginning to show up a few days later in the insights? Well, hopefully they are. And if they're not, then what is working within your insights? So that's the first question. The second question is, in your insights, what hasn't worked? So it could be you're trying something and it just isn't working. Or maybe you need to put focus on something that is going to work, something that's already proving to work. Third question, what keywords and images brought in traffic? So you just need to look for your images, see what's bringing in traffic, maybe look at the views. So that isn't necessarily an insight. You can get that information just by going to your photo gallery. It gives you there the idea of how many people have seen it, how often it's occurred in search terms and so on. And finally, will you make a plan for this info? So again, it's about really not just listening to this video, but it's about thinking about what are you going to do? Maybe if you've got a pen and paper now, jot down what it is you're going to do with that information. Now I'm going to take a second look at my insights for Zanet Design. And the reason I'm interested is I've been working on branding. I try and get my logo on all the videos I'm doing, and I'm just intending to try and get my branding out there. So you probably know that Zanet Design, if you did a search for that on YouTube, you'd probably come up with one of my videos. And the idea is that when people are looking for Google My Business or a web designer, they think of Zanet Design. They do a search into Google for Zanet Design and they then click on my business. And if they see my knowledge panel or see my website, Google's taking a note of that. And what I'm doing is I'm building up an expertise, a trustworthiness, an authority, which is EAT, which we've looked at before in a previous video. But it's also letting Google know that I am a brand in what I'm doing. And that's covered in insights. Now, I want to know, is that growing? Ideally, we want this to be a big chunk of traffic. It's very hard to do. Most people don't get any branding at all showing on Google My Business Insights. But I'm going to show you now my insights and let's see how it stands. So I've logged into my insights, or I've logged into my account. I'm going to go into insights and it's the yellow bit I'm looking for, and that's great to see. So 17.8% or 876 people are customers who have found me by searching for my brand. So this is good to see. This is good. So it means basically people are looking for Zanet Design rather than the web designer and then finding me, or rather than just typing in my web address, which is the direct or the discovery, this is where people know about me. So this is returning people, people that have heard about me, people that want to know more about me. And so branding is an important element that I've been working on. So that's good to see. So that's what shows me that Zanet Design and my efforts in that are beginning to work. I've got more interaction coming through because it's beginning to grow again. My difficulty's been that I've not been focusing on web design at all. It's a web design company, but if I keep talking about Google My Business, that seems to be kind of confusing, the fact that I'm a web designer. And maybe I'm at a crossroads where maybe I should just be focusing on Google My Business now. And when I start to look through last month, I noticed I was getting a lot more to do with Google My Business. In fact, web design is not showing. And the challenge is I'm getting Google Maps, that's huge. So my challenge is that I'm kind of, my business is moving into something different. So if you looked at my keywords, it's dictating that people are finding me on Google My Business. Google My Business login, Google Maps, Google reviews. There's no mention of web design. So I've pretty much disintegrated my business. There we go. So number 15 and 17 people found it. Yeah, I need to rethink my strategy as a business owner, because in some ways what I've built up is confusing Google now. And maybe I should just be focusing on helping other people just optimize their Google My Business listings. So that's something I really need to grapple with and something I need to think about based on my insights. So in some ways, I think my problem is probably bigger than yours, because I'm changing my business live before you as an audience. And that may well be a video or two that I need to make. So if you're interested in seeing a video on that, if you think I should be changing my business to Google My Business optimization and moving away from web design, put a comment down below. I really want to hear what you think I should do with my insights because this is quite interesting.
So as always, this is an interactive type of video. Obviously, I can't correspond to exactly what you're thinking and how your business is working, but there are some things I'm going to ask you to do. And again, use the comments down below if you want to feedback information to me.
So here's the first thing. Locate the keywords that visitors are finding you on. So find out, particularly if they're more than 10 or 15 of a particular keyword, locate them and use them in your next post. The second thing is discern what ways visitors are contacting you. So are they calling you? Are they using a booking form? And again, you might want to use that when you do your next post or your next offer, then there's a button you can decide. So if they're calling you on the phone, then make sure you put the call button there. If they're tending to want to book online, then use your booking button. So you can select the button that fits what your customers are using most. And finally, what are you going to change over the next 2 weeks? Well, that's really about planning ahead. Maybe for the next few videos, we've got a post coming up soon. We've got a few offers to do in a few days' time. So just think about what are you going to use from this insight information today to help you in the coming 2 weeks as we work together. So we're now officially halfway through this challenge. Hopefully you're still with us. If you did miss any, then you can always go back to the playlist and look back over the past 14 days. But tomorrow is day 16. And I'm going to say this to you, If you want to know what that means, then tune in on tomorrow's challenge. I'll see you there.